everyone. In the previous session, we just saw how to draw the schematic diagram in the KiCAD software. And I hope you're clear with it. Now, there are other two concepts rather than drawing this schematic diagram. What are those two concepts? One is the label concept, while the other one is the bus concepts. Generally, if you just wanted to design a circuit, for example, a circuit with only ICs and without any components, there we just can't implement the schematic diagram. We need to just go or opt for an other concept. What is that concept? There we are going to use this label concept. So now let us just take 2555 timer ICs. So click play symbols and click at any part of your worksheet. Now write LM555. You've got it. Just click that and click OK. The first IC is pasted. We want two ICs because we are going to give connection in between two LN555 ICs. After pasting that, just zoom in to get a clear view. Now you can just notice that both my ICs are not just in the same or a proper contact. It's just connected in the same line so that whenever you're giving in connection, there won't be any confusion. Now just move towards your right side and click place wire for connecting the wires. The third pin of the first IC is connected to the third pin of the second IC. The seventh pin of the first IC is connected to the seventh pin of the second IC. The sixth pin of the first IC is connected to the sixth pin of the second IC. The second pin of the first IC is connected to the second pin of the second IC. The fifth pin of the first IC is connected to the eighth pin of the second IC. And the fourth pin of the first IC is connected to the fourth pin of the second IC. And the first pin of the first IC is just connected to the fifth pin of the second IC. And now there is one more connection left out. If you notice keenly, you can just see that the eighth and the first pin is left out. Now we need to connect the 8th pin of the first IC to the first pin of the second IC. Now, just please, anyone can remember the connections that I have given earlier that is on this circuit? No, none of them can remember. Whenever you see this circuit, you just cannot identify the connections that are given. Why is that so? This circuit just seems to be complicated. Can't this complication be reduced, or you have any other idea to give a separate connection so that these ICs look better even when they are given in the connection? Yes, there is an alternative way to just connect the ICs. What is that way? There goes the label concept. Now, again, we shall choose two LM555 timers to show the better way. Okay. Again, click on OK. Now, on the same icon, move towards the downwards. And now you can just notice place net label, an icon that is the ninth icon with a text named A that is underlined. Just click that and keep the cursor on the third pin of the first IC and click. There you can see a box that is appeared written as text. So there you have to write the letter Q, because the text Q is present on the side of the third pin. So just write Q and click OK. Now paste that Q nearby to the side of third pin. And now this Q connection of the third pin is connected to the third pin of the second IC. So there again click and write Q, click OK and paste it nearby the third pin. The same one is repeated for the seventh pin also. Click OK, paste it in the nearby sides, repeat the same procedure. Notice the names that are present inside your ICs. The second pin is also connected to the second pin of the second IC. The fifth pin is connected to the eighth pin. So the fifth pin of the first IC is named as CB, and it is connected to the eighth pin of the second IC. So the eighth pin of the second IC must also be named as CB. And the fourth pin is again connected to the fourth pin only. So name it as R, since it is written as R inside the text box. Now the ground one is connected to the fifth pin of the second IC. So the fifth pin of the second IC must also be named as ground. That is, the ground connection of the first IC is connected to the fifth pin of the second IC, and the VCC of the first IC is connected to the first pin of the second IC. So now the entire connection is finished. If you zoom in, you can just get a clear view that the third pin of the first IC is connected to the third pin of the second IC. The seventh pin of the first IC is connected to the seventh pin of the second IC. The sixth pin of the first IC is connected to the sixth pin of the second IC. The eighth pin of the first IC is connected to the first pin of the second IC. The first pin of the first IC is connected to the fifth pin of the second IC. The second pin of the first IC is therefore connected to the second pin of the second IC. The fifth pin of the first IC is connected to the eighth pin of the second IC. The fourth pin of the first IC is connected to the fourth pin of the second IC. Now just you even can check the differentiation between these two ICs. How many of them are clear with this one? None, including me, because even I cannot identify the connection that I've given. Whether it is right or not, I cannot check, because it is such in manner that this connection looks so clumsy. Whereas the second IC, that is, I've used the label concept over here, so this looks even more pretty and even more neat and simple. So this is the reason why we used label concept, and I hope you are clear with it.